Good morning. It's March 18th, and this is your daily brief in science. Here's everything you need to know. In a groundbreaking report published in The Lancet Neurology, a staggering 3.4 billion people worldwide are grappling with neurological disorders, a figure that underscores the pervasive impact of conditions like strokes, migraines, and dementia on global health. The Global Burden of Disease study has unveiled a 59% surge in neurological conditions since 1990. This increase is significant, yet when adjustments are made for population growth and aging, there's a silver lining. The rate of disability-adjusted life years, DALYs, and deaths attributed to neurological disorders has seen a decrease. This nuanced finding suggests progress amid the rising numbers. However, the study doesn't shy away from highlighting the uneven distribution of this burden. It reveals notable disparities in the prevalence and impact of neurological diseases across different regions and between genders, pointing to a complex web of factors influencing these conditions. Among the key revelations is the identification of modifiable risk factors, such as high blood pressure and air pollution. This insight offers a glimmer of hope, suggesting that targeted interventions in these areas could significantly reduce the burden of neurological diseases. The World Health Organization has seized upon these findings, calling for urgent action to improve access to quality care and treatment for those affected by neurological disorders. This call to action emphasizes the critical need for global efforts to address this growing challenge and ensure better health outcomes for millions around the world. In the realm of medical science, a recent study has illuminated the dark corners of chronic nasal inflammation, revealing a potential villain in the saga of chronic rhinosinusitis. This groundbreaking research delves into how the secreted factors of Staphylococcus aureus biofilms impact the nasal mucosa, particularly in the context of long-term exposure. The study meticulously investigated the effects of Staphylococcus aureus biofilm secreted factors, SABSFs, on rat nasal mucosa over an extended period. The findings were striking, showing that chronic exposure to these factors triggers inflammation characterized by a significant infiltration of T lymphocytes. This inflammation was not uniform, but instead spread out in multiple foci across the nasal mucosa. Among the various strains of S. aureus examined, the one isolated from a patient suffering from chronic rhinosinusitis with nasal polyps, CRSWNP, was found to induce the most severe inflammatory reactions. The damage was extensive, including goblet cell hyperplasia and a notable infiltration of mast cells, pointing to a vigorous immune response being mounted against the SABSFs. Further analysis using transcriptomic techniques shed light on the underlying mechanisms. It revealed that the immune response pathways were significantly activated in the tissues exposed to SABSFs, with the strains associated with CRSWNP and CRSSNP, eliciting a more pronounced immune reaction. This suggests that S. aureus, through its biofilm secreted factors, could be a key player in the development and exacerbation of chronic rhinosinusitis. The implications of this research are profound, offering new insights into how chronic rhinosinusitis may develop, and pointing towards potential therapeutic targets. It underscores the critical role of S. aureus in driving nasal mucosa inflammation, paving the way for novel treatment strategies in managing this challenging condition. In a bold move that could upend centuries of cosmological theory, a study from the University of Ottawa casts a shadow of doubt on the existence of dark matter, an entity that has long been a cornerstone of our understanding of the universe. This research, making waves in the scientific community, proposes a universe where dark matter might not be necessary at all. Published in the Astrophysical Journal, the study introduces what's known as the CCC plus TL model. This model presents a groundbreaking alternative explanation for the universe's accelerated expansion, a phenomenon traditionally attributed to dark matter and dark energy. According to this new theory, the acceleration we observe is actually due to the diminishing strength of nature's forces over time, not the presence of unseen matter or energy. The mastermind behind this revolutionary concept is Professor Rajendra Gupta of the University of Ottawa. Gupta's work challenges the prevailing dark matter-centric model, suggesting that our understanding of cosmic phenomena needs a significant overhaul. By proposing a universe without the need for dark matter, Gupta advocates for a paradigm shift in how we perceive the cosmos. If validated, Gupta's CCC plus TL model could fundamentally alter the scientific community's grasp of cosmological principles. This theory not only questions the existence of dark matter, but also prompts a reevaluation of fundamental theories that have shaped our understanding of the universe. The implications of such a shift are profound, potentially revolutionizing our comprehension of the cosmos and its underlying mechanisms. In the realm of stroke recovery, a new beacon of hope shines through the innovative use of technology. Recent studies have unveiled the promising potential of repetitive transcranial magnetic stimulation, or RTMS, in enhancing the brain's natural healing process after a stroke. These investigations have shed light on how RTMS, a non-invasive brain stimulation technique, may significantly impact neuroplasticity, the brain's ability to reorganize itself by forming new neural connections. The studies found that RTMS was associated with elevated levels of specific biomarkers linked to neuroplasticity. This suggests that RTMS could positively influence the brain's endogenous plasticity mechanisms, offering a glimmer of hope for stroke survivors navigating the challenging journey of recovery. Moreover, the research highlights the potential therapeutic benefits of high-frequency RTMS in particular. This form of stimulation is believed to aid stroke recovery by promoting neurogenesis, the creation of new neurons, and axogenesis, the growth of new axons. These processes are crucial for the restoration of neural networks damaged by stroke. The findings from these studies underscore the potential of TMS as a beneficial, non-invasive treatment option for those recovering from strokes. By harnessing the power of RTMS to stimulate the brain's natural repair mechanisms, medical professionals may be able to offer more effective rehabilitation strategies for stroke survivors, potentially improving quality of life and accelerating the recovery process. In a breakthrough study published in Molecular Psychiatry, scientists have discovered that psilocybin mushroom extract might offer more profound therapeutic benefits for psychiatric disorders than its synthetic counterpart. This research, focusing on the effects in mice, opens a new chapter in the quest for effective mental health treatments. The study revealed that the mushroom extract led to significantly greater increases in synaptic protein levels, which are vital for neuroplasticity, compared to the synthetic psilocybin. This suggests that the natural extract could be more effective in promoting brain health and function. Furthermore, the researchers noted unique metabolic changes in the brain triggered by the mushroom extract, hinting at a complex entourage effect where multiple components within the extract work together more effectively than a single synthesized compound. Interestingly, the study observed no notable difference in the immediate behavioral responses between the two forms of psilocybin treatment in mice. This finding underscores the complexity of how these treatments work and the need for deeper investigation. The researchers have emphasized the importance of conducting further empirical studies in humans to validate these findings and explore the additional components present in the mushroom extract that may contribute to its enhanced therapeutic effects. The long-term goal of this research is not just academic curiosity. By understanding the differences between mushroom extract and synthesized psilocybin, scientists hope to pave the way for developing more effective treatments for psychiatric disorders. This study marks a significant step forward in the exploration of natural substances for mental health care, with the potential to revolutionize treatment approaches in the future. This has been your daily brief in science. To read more about these stories, follow the links in the episode bio. You can also subscribe to these updates via email at www.brief.news. For more daily podcasts about the topics you love, visit brief.news/podcasts. Tune in tomorrow. We'll be back with everything you need to know.